Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to work with quadratic equations and synthetic division to find all the zeros for this particular problem. So given that we know negative 3 is a zero or a solution to the polynomial that we see below, we need to find all the other zeros. So let's begin by using synthetic division. They've given us one of the zeros, which is negative 3. And now I need to list the coefficients for each one of these terms in my polynomial. So for the x to the third, its coefficient or number in front is a 1. For the x squared, I'm using a 7. For the 11x, it's 11. And my constant here is negative 3. And I begin by dropping down my first number, which is a 1. So negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. 7 minus 3 gives me 4. Negative 3 times 4 gives me a negative 12, and 11 minus 12 gives me a negative 1, and then negative 3 times negative 1 gives me a positive 3, and just as it said, negative 3 is a root or a 0, because I see my remainder here is 0. What I'm able to do now is that once I complete the synthetic division and find out that I do in fact have a zero or a root, the degree of this polynomial has been downgraded by one or decremented by one. So here I take each one of these here become the coefficients of my new polynomial. So the first term will be x squared, the second term is going to be a positive 4x, and then my constant is going to be negative 1. So this here is my new polynomial. And as I look at this polynomial, I see I'm going to have to use the quadratic equation to solve it. And again, the quadratic equation is negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, where all of that is divided by 2a. And in this problem, a is 1, b corresponds to the 4, and c corresponds to the negative 1. So at this point, I just do a straight substitution. So negative b will give me a negative 4 plus or minus b squared, which will be 4 to the second power, which is 16, minus 4 times a, which in this case is 1, and c is negative 1. All that needs to be divided by 2 times 1, which is just 2. I continue to simplify. Negative 4 plus or minus. Here I have 16. I have a negative 4 times a negative 1 times a negative 1, which gives me a positive 4, because a negative times a negative is a positive. And again, I continue to divide by 2. Let's scroll down and continue. I have negative 4 plus or minus. Well, 16 plus 4 gives me 20. And my denominator here is a 2. I can use prime factorization because I need to break down this root 20. Well, 20 is the same thing as 5 times 4, and 4 is the same thing as 2 times 2. I've broken this down to its prime factors, and I see I have a pair of 2's, so that means the 2's can't escape the radical here. So I have negative 4 plus or minus 2, and what's left behind is the root 5. And all of that is divided by 2. Again, I can continue to solve or work on this problem because I see that each one of these terms has a common factor of 2, so everything can be divided by 2. So here, 2 goes into negative 4, leaving me a negative 2. 2 divided by 2 leaves me with 1, which I don't have to write, so I just keep my root 5. And this denominator, 2 divided by 2 is 1, and I don't need to write a 1 as my denominator. So these here are the other two roots that, or the other two zeros, that solve this particular polynomial. Alright, that summed it up for this video from Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name, and thank you again for watching.